Judge Trump?
Thank you. My judicial philosophy, I outlined it somewhat in my opening statement, and I adhere strongly to the views that Justice Scalia had on the way that we interpret statutes and the way that we interpret the Constitution. And so when the court is asked what the law says, particularly if it's a statute, we begin with the text of the statute. And I'm so thankful for Justice Sykes when she was on our state Supreme Court, and she gave us the gift of Kalal, where she outlined the proper way to interpret a statute. And I do believe that it's important that you begin with the text of the statute. We don't look first to what the legislature may have thought they wanted to do. We don't apply the legislature's unenacted intent, but we apply the language that they chose to use when they adopted the statute. When we look at constitutional questions, I agree with Justice Scalia that the task of the court is to try to understand what was the original understanding at the time, the original public understanding of the constitutional provision at issue. Now, when I talk about the rule of law, it is not a mantra. I believe it is critically important that our next justice of the Wisconsin Supreme Court follows the rule of law, which is that courts, when they're doing their work, begin with the facts and the questions of the case that they have been given, that comes to them. They do the research, and they go where the law takes them. That's what Justice John Wilcox told me when I talked with him last summer. He did when he was on the court. You do the research and you go where the law takes you. You do not decide how you want the case to come out and then find a path to this. This is one of the areas where I do not believe it is correct to follow Stephen Covey's example and begin with the end in mind. You begin with the case as you find it. You do the research, you go where the law takes you. And I do not care what my political beliefs are. It does not matter what my preferences are. And I am telling you and I am committing to you that I will set those aside, and I know that I can do it. I've done it on the bench. Now, Judge Dalla talks about my work on Act 10. Those of you in the room who are attorneys know your role as an attorney is to be an advocate for your client's interests. You get a case to you, it comes to you, you do all that you can to vigorously advocate for the interests of your client. Governor Walker hired our law firm to assist with the Attorney General's Office in defending Act 10. Our law firm looked around at the 200 plus lawyers that they had in the firm and selected three for that important task. I was one of those three. I'm proud of that work. I know Act 10 inside and out. I know the legal arguments that were raised inside and out. And I know that the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals said there was no constitutional impediment, no constitutional problem with Act 10. Our state Supreme Court said the same thing. That's the role of the court. When the legislature acts and the governor acts and the case comes to the court, the question is, did one of those political branches exceed their constitutional boundaries? And if the answer is no, the court must remain hands off. Whether I like the policy choices that they selected or not, it is not the role of the court, a judge, or an individual justice to decide that they know better what would make good policy. To me, that is what that's what I mean when I say the rule of law. I am committed to it. Judge Dalla thinks that my saying it is garbage and that I will only apply it until some case comes along that I don't like the result, and she's just wrong.